Well, it is about that time, and it is time for Ready, Set, Real Estate, and I am so stoked, as always, you guys, to bring valuable information. So today I'm calling this Interrupting Our Regularly Scheduled Program to bring much needed information to the forefront. And we are going to be talking about foreclosures. And in particular, this is going to be about foreclosures in Inglewood and in the surrounding areas. So those of you who are native to Cali, native to LA, this is for you. And so my guest today, Jenn Laurent, who is a broker. I'm so excited to connect with this sister because she is just as empowered, armed, equipped with this information. So Jenn, welcome to the show. I am so excited to have you. And we are going to, we're really going to talk about what needs to be talked about.
Thanks for having me. I appreciate the opportunity and the chance to work with you. So thank you so much.
Absolutely. So for those of you who are not familiar with foreclosures, right? So what we like to do, Jenn, on the show is keep it real basic, powerful, sweet, and that way we cover definitions. So this is a platform where we are arming and educating people with terms and concepts. For those who are not familiar with foreclosures, would you break that down for us just as basic as it can get so that people really can overstand, is what I like to say, what foreclosures mean? And then we'll talk about the significance of the impact in our surrounding communities.
Okay, I can do that. So essentially what a foreclosure is, in the state of California, every state has different foreclosure laws, but in the state of California, what happens is once you get behind so far on your mortgage, then the lender can start the foreclosure process. And it's actually a multi-stage process. So initially what they'll do is they'll file what's called a notice of default. And when I say file a notice of default, they send a copy to you, but they also file a copy with the LA or the county recorder's office for whatever county that you're in. This makes it part of public record. And you start in that notice of default stage and you're there for approximately 90 days. 90 days after the notice of default has been filed, if you have not been able to work out a solution with the lender, catch up on your payments, or exercise some of your other options, then the lender will file the next step, which is called a notice of trustee sale. And again, when I say filed, that means they file this document with the county recorder's office. From the date that they file, they usually schedule a foreclosure auction approximately 21 days from the date of that notice of trustee sale. And when I say, and then your property can go to auction. So when it goes to auction, it's an actual public auction. And they're held at different locations. Sometimes it may be held on the steps of a recorder's office. I've seen some where they've been held at like a banquet room, at like a DoubleTree, you know, different venues. But it's actually a public auction. And people can go in and bid for your property. And the highest bidder will be awarded that property. If no one bids on the property, then the property goes back to the bank. And once it goes back to the bank, that's when you start hearing the term REO, which means real estate owned. And once it goes back to the bank, then usually what will happen is the owners or the tenants, whoever's occupying the property, they sometimes will try to negotiate with you to move out. Other times they may start an unlawful detainer process to get the occupants out of the house, so that whether it's a new private owner who purchased the property at the auction, or if it's the bank, they can get the property vacant, so then they can do whatever it is they want to do with the property after that.
Wow. For those of you who just tuned in, please hit the replay button on this, because that was about 30-second to 45-second worth of wealth of information on foreclosures. So, Jen, thank you so much, because you basically truncated the entire experience, litigation, and I tell folks, right, this is litigation that you're experiencing if you find yourself in that situation. So let's talk about, so just a little bit about your background, because it'll kind of fill in for those who are not familiar with you, just your background and how you're able to kind of, care comes in my mind, because that's what you exude. The fact that, see, Jen and I connected on Facebook, and thankfully, those of you who are utilizing social media to connect and expand and build your networks, which is what I always say, I invite you to connect, build, and share with me. Jen was one of those people, individuals that had shared a post that garnered a lot of attention, and it had to do with foreclosure. It had to do with investors. It had to do with what's going on with why we're not having a conversation amongst each other in the community. Why are we not getting the resource? So Jen, share with us your background in real estate, and then we'll get into what I'm excited about, what you're doing, which is a private webinar on foreclosures in Inglewood.
Okay. I fell into this business kind of by accident. I met someone, and this is back in probably the early 2000s, and he said he was a real estate investor. So I was curious about what he did, and I actually worked with him for a while. And what we would do is we'd get a foreclosure list. A few minutes ago, I talked about how the notice of default is filed with the county recorder's office. Well, there are companies that go and they put all of the information, all of the notice of defaults together into a list, and they sell these lists to investors. So we would get this list every day, and we each had an area. We'd go out and we'd knock on the homeowner's door. Hey, I see that, you know, home, that the bank is, you know, saying that you're behind on your payments. You know, how can we help you? His end goal was, of course, to buy the property. But what started happening for me is that as I'm talking to the families and different things like that, I want to, well, how can I help you? How can I keep help you stay in your home? What caused this? And back at that time, there were actually loans where you could refinance out of foreclosure as long as you had a certain amount of equity. So in doing that, I was trained on how to recognize a distressed property. There's certain things that you look for, you know, the condition of the property from the outside, if there's been notices, you know, posted on the door, if the property looks vacant, and things like that. So that's always stayed with me. So after I stopped working with the investor, I ended up getting my real estate, my salesperson's license. I started doing loans, worked for a couple of big banks, Chase, Bank of America, worked for some individual mortgage brokers, and then I ended up getting my broker's license. So for me, for the past couple of years, I focused on the loan side, helping people get into homes, first-time buyer programs and things of that nature. But I decided I want to go back on the listing and sales side right now, because I see so many homes in so many areas where the values are appreciating and people are still going into foreclosure, getting that notice of default, getting that notice of trustee sale, and actually losing their properties. And that's what my Facebook post was actually about. And kind of what started this for me in the Inglewood area is I've been in Inglewood for only about 3 years. I take my grandkids to school, and they both go to school in Inglewood. So as I'm driving, you know, down Venice, up Fifth Avenue, you know, whatever the case may be, I started seeing for sale signs. there are certain agents who are well-known foreclosure agents or REO agents, agents who work for the banks. So, for example, there's Philip Baroda, who works through Coldwell Banker out of Beverly Hills. I saw one of his signs in the front yard of a home on Van Ness in, I want to say, 81st or 82nd. And, you know, kind of struck me as odd. Wow, why is that an REO when the values up here are going up so high? The other thing I started noticing is the big storage pods. You know how they deliver pods to your front yard and you can put all your things in it? Usually that's an indication of someone packing up their stuff. I'm kind of nosy. I would see those. I'd go back and run the address. And sure enough, it would be someone who was notice of default or on foreclosure. So from there, I go on Zillow. And for example, today, if you go on Zillow and you search for foreclosure homes in Inglewood, Zillow is going to tell you there's approximately 113 homes today that are in some stage of foreclosure, whether it's pre-foreclosure, which is notice of default, or foreclosure, where they have that notice of trustee sale. So looking at these numbers and these signs and different things like that, it clicked in my head, okay, there's definitely a need for this conversation, because with all of the development, with the stadium coming, if you want to call it gentrification, redevelopment, however you want to term it, our property values over here are skyrocketing. And in my opinion, there's no reason that someone should have to lose their home to the bank or to an investor when they have a tremendous amount of equity in their home.
Absolutely. And I'm so glad that you are stepping up, especially when I look at those who are either watching, and I've been privy to some of the conversations that have been happening over time, is everyone is rattled about what's happening, but what are we doing about it, right? So what resources are available? Are you talking to someone? Are we getting to a place? And I've said this, I've spoken to my partner about this. If I can find the formula to figure out a way that we can help those individuals and or families that are facing foreclosure, like, that's the code. What is the code in helping? Because it all goes for naught. And I think you had shared just kind of a perspective, which was very profound and interesting, that became a dinner table conversation with my family last night. Because again, we are watching, and it is public information when the notice of default and the filings take place on the property. So it's no secret anymore. The cat is out the bag. And so again, it became a point of conversation, because I said, well, as a professional, we're reaching out to people to help, and they don't respond or they're non-responsive. And then you see that the bank ends up getting it. And you painted such a picture that was so profound, where you said that was an opportunity for business, or just kind of, especially with us, we earn our income from commission. So that was a sales opportunity that goes to feed our family, that allows, it's a cycle, right? And then that person could have had equity in their property that they can then take the proceeds of the sale and do either downsize or transition to something else. And life is not completely over when you lose your property. So I'm a little bit more passionate about this, especially because, you know, I'm out in the field, I'm door knocking, we're active, right? We're proactive and trying to be a resource rather than being reactive and sitting back and saying, well, oh, we couldn't help. So I'm really happy that you're doing this. So tell us a little bit more about your upcoming webinar that will be covering foreclosures. And so you guys who are listening to the replay, thank you. Make sure you hit the link, you register. This is a private webinar that I'm glad she's indicating that we're making sure that we can create a platform where we have the conversation, especially because a lot of you are scrolling on your timeline anyway. So why not come get some foreclosure information and get the resources that you need? So tell us a little bit more about your webinar.
Okay, well, the reason
I'm so happy that you're doing it, that's why.
The reason I decided to do a webinar is because it's, in my experience, and you may have experienced this door knocking, when I was working with the investor, oftentimes you knock on someone's door And they're like, well, I'm going to work it out. I'm praying on it. My family said they're going to come up with the money. I mean, they have all of these reasons and what they believe are solid options to get out of foreclosure. And 9 times out of 10, these options weren't panning out. The other part of it is, like you were mentioning, the cat is out of the bag. Once that notice of default is filed and it becomes public record, then the homeowner is inundated with mailers, people knocking on the door, people calling on the phone, these things like that. It becomes very overwhelming. And sometimes it's like, if you don't know what your true options are, how do you compare it to what you're hearing? How do you know what's real? You know, some people will come and they'll say, oh, you know, you're in foreclosure. The bank is going to come lock your house, so you need to sell it to me today. No, that's not true. You know, you might get letters from a bankruptcy attorney and, you know, trying to understand, well, is bankruptcy really going to work? If you do a Chapter 13, the Chapter 13 will help you catch up on the past due plans, but you still have to make your current mortgage payment as well. So if you've come into a financial situation where you can barely afford the first, the mortgage payment, which is what got you into the situation, have your finances improved to the point where you can make the past due payments to the bankruptcy court and keep up with the regular payment. So there's a lot of information and education to be had by homeowners so that they know, you know, kind of they can weed through the offers that they're getting. They can understand what their real options are. And sometimes if things sound too good to be true, it probably is. You know, so that's the first piece. The other thing is, because I know your credit, your income, your home, for a lot of us, that's tied to our sense of self, that's tied to our self-esteem, and to how we believe other people are going to view us. So there are a lot of agencies that do foreclosure counseling seminars, West Angeles CDC, Los Angeles Neighborhood Housing. You can go on the internet and Google HUD approved counseling agency and find different nonprofits that can do counseling for foreclosures. But here's the thing, very few people will want to come and sit in a room with a bunch of other people and have everyone know that you're in foreclosure, that you're having some kind of financial issue. So a light bulb went on in my head. Well, what if we do a webinar? You know, that way the person can log in from wherever they are. Nobody has to know your business, and you can get the information that you need. And if you want to ask questions, then you can reach out, you know, via chat or whatever, later on through email or social media, and get, you know, private one-on-one information. So I'm hoping that will encourage people to participate in the conversation, to get information and to get answers. Because in the Facebook post that I did that you mentioned that got so much response, it was a homeowner who owed the bank $260,000. Their property went to auction. An investor paid $413,000 for it. And now that investor has painted it, fixed it up, and has it on the market for $549,000. That's equity that could have gone directly to that homeowner. And I use it in the example, even if the homeowner only listed it for $413,000, the difference between that and the $260,000 they owed the bank was a little over $140,000. A couple of things with that. They could have, you know, had that money to start over. And here's the thing with foreclosure. When you have a foreclosure on your history, you cannot get another home loan for 3 to 7 years. If you get an FHA loan, then you can get it in 3 years. But for a conventional loan, it takes 7 years. And I want to stress that, because where you are today may completely change within the next 7 years. So, for example, I have a client. He owns several pieces of property. And when we had the big mortgage implosion back in, you know, 2008, 2009, he let one of his investment properties go as a foreclosure. So now here we are 6 years later, and his credit is rebuilt. He's got great income. His primary residence is now worth close to $1 million. Well, he had refinanced it with an FHA loan. He only owes about $400,000 on this loan. He wants to get rid of his PMI so he can lower his payment by $200 a month, but he cannot get a conventional loan because that 7-year period is not up. So again, the reason for, you know, talking to someone before it gets to that foreclosure stage, because you don't know what the implications are going to be further down the line. I can talk forever, but
it's completely fine. Didn't I say, I said, see, I can do master teacher, master student. And so with my guests, I'll let you roll. I am entrusting you, especially as another professional, and the fact that you're stepping out and you're doing something about it. I love you and I highly respect you for it, because that's what we need to see as a collective among industries, in among professionals in the industry, especially because there's so much happening. And I'm like, look, I'm reading these threads in the Leimert Park groups and the Inglewood groups and the LA groups and the Watts groups and the Compton groups and the Hawthorne groups, all these areas that are completely going through changes and redevelopment. And like you said, call it what it is. Yes, it's changes that's happening. So what resources do people have available? And I'm really happy that we can utilize social media to talk about it. One, two, create a online community about it, which is to register for the webinar, which I'm highlighting it here, Jen, for you. It's March 7th. It's a 7 o'clock Pacific time, correct?
Yes.
So it's going to run about 1 hour, you guys. And I'm not sure if you had already touched on who's going to be on the panel. But, oh, you did. Excuse me. Cause I was listening and I'm like, yes, I'm so excited because this information is so, so needed. I'm so happy that you talked about the counseling agencies and the various organizations that are available to help. So we've got to stop wearing the shame hat. It ends today. It ends today. We have got to do something different in order to get different results, right? Let's not do the insanity, doing the same thing over and over, expecting different results. And also ignoring the calls and the letters. And I get it. It's difficult to pick what agent out of 50 to work with. But, you know, you got to start somewhere. So certainly. I'm so happy about that, Jen. So you can all connect with Jen. She's on Facebook. Her social media is, what's your Facebook tag name?
Jenn Laurent.
Look, Jenn Laurent on Facebook. You can definitely click on the link in the comment box, you guys. It'll take you straight to the Eventbrite to get registered for the webinar. That way you can be part of, I think, something very significant that's happening right now. And I'm all for webinars. Let me say this. I appreciate live workshops, but with life happening, with also the mental, spiritual, the emotional weight that people are carrying when you're dealing with financial strains, it's very difficult to get up and show up. And so I really appreciate that Jen and the team is creating a platform, an online community, that way you can participate. And if you want it to be one-on-one, you can take it offline with the people that you're connected with. So I think this is great. And I'm excited because I you know me, I'm webinars. I'm all for webinars. I teach the babies on webinars. And so it's great that we can offer something for the community so we can stop complaining, chatting, ranting, rambling, and be proactive and do something about it. So for those of you who are going on and on about, hey, you know, they took my house or they did this, they did that. Guess what? The onus is here.
Definitely. And also, I wanted to mention, this webinar is not just for people who are in danger right now of going into foreclosure, but it's for everyone, so that you do have the knowledge, because one of the panelists will be a lender. And we can kind of look at certain types of loans that have a history of going into default, going into foreclosure. And then there's some loan programs that people took out several years ago that may be changing, and it's going to be important for them, especially now that we're in a rising interest rate market, to look at that, to do a mortgage analysis and see where you are and how these rising interest rates are going to affect you. For example, people who took out HELOCs, home equity lines of credit, you know, within the last 10 years. Most HELOCs are set up where for the first 10 years, you're only paying interest, and it's kind of an open-end loan against your house, and you can reuse it and reuse it. But after the 10th year, it becomes a closed-end loan. And then you start paying principal and interest. So I had a client, for example, her interest-only payment was $132 a month, but once it changed into a closed-end loan and she's paying principal and interest, her payment went to $800 a month. That's a huge difference, a huge jump from $132 to $800. So that is somewhere where someone can potentially get behind on their mortgage and fall into foreclosure. For the last few years, we've been in a very low interest rate market. So people were taking adjustables where it changes every month, or they were doing the hybrid ARMs where it's a, you know, fixed for 5 years, 7 years. Well, if you're at the end of that 5 or 7 year term and rates right now, you know, the last couple of years, they've been in the high threes, low fours. Now we're in the high fours, low fives. So if your rate is starting to go up, that means your payment is starting to go up as well. You know, now may be the time to sit down with a lender and, you know, weigh your options. Do I kind of, you know, stay where I am and see what happens, or should I go ahead and take a fixed rate now and know that I'm locked in at, you know, 4.75 for the next 30 years because I don't know what's going to happen in the market. But the adjustable is another mortgage product where the changes can cause people to get behind. So again, this webinar is not just for people who are currently in foreclosure, it's actually for everyone. Just to get the information, to get the knowledge. Another panelist is a real estate attorney, you know, and I wanted to have a real estate attorney on there because another way that I see us losing property in the community is when an older person dies. You know, if there's a small mortgage left on the house, there are certain things that the family needs to do. In my opinion, you know, a trust is a good vehicle to put your property in so that when the person passes, you don't have to go through the probate court. Oftentimes I've seen families get caught up in the probate court, either with the expense of the probate attorney's fees, or fighting amongst themselves to decide who's going to be the administrator of the estate and be able to make decisions. And while the family is fighting and going through this court process, the bank is continuing with the foreclosure process. So there's so many like day-to-day things that can happen that can put someone into foreclosure that, again, getting the information up front, it's kind of like going through a fire drill. You know, you do it, you do it, you do it. And when the fire happens, then you just jump into that response mode and you know what to do. So that's what I'm hoping will, you know, come out of this webinar is just getting the information out there so people know what to do. And another thing that resonates with me is that, you know, we talk about gentrification of our communities, Leimert Park, West Adams, Inglewood. There was recently an article in the LA Times that said the next new and up and coming area is going to be South LA, Watts and Compton. I've been attending some of the gentrification workshops, you know, that are being held, community meetings, churches, and different things like that. And it's like, yes, there are arguments on this side, and there are valid things that we can do. In Inglewood, there's a petition going around about rent control and different things like that. But at the same time, those external things are happening to us. I believe that, you know, at a certain point, we need to figure out, you know, how can we get together, mobilize, protect our own assets, pool our resources in the community as a community. Because, again, we can do meetings and marches and protests and petitions, but that building over where Daniel Freeman used to be is still going to be built. And those condos are still going to have a price point at close to $1 million. So I think things need to be addressed in different ways from all sides. And one of those ways is for us to have more knowledge and education, number one, about how to get into a home, because our homeownership rates are lower than everyone else's, and then also how to keep that home once we're in there, because our foreclosure rates tend to be a little bit higher. So it's just like a multi-sided, multifaceted conversation that needs to be had.
Right, right. And we've had it here. And this is a snippet of it. I thank you, Jen. We're going to wrap it up. I like to keep it short and sweet, but this was definitely powerful. If you're catching us on the replay, thank you. Be sure to invite someone to share and be sure to invite someone to register for the upcoming webinar covering foreclosures. And I'm glad Jen said it. You don't have to be facing foreclosure to be a part of this, but it's good to be armed to see post home ownership and also pre home ownership, right? How do you even get into a home? As she said, that she'll have the professionals on the panel that will be able to share with you. And I think it's great because I'm a webinar person. Didn't I share with you offline? I'm spoiled because I just like having this camera here at my, that I could just do everything right here. And if we can get this information out to everyone instead of me trying to hope, beg, and plead for people to show up to a live workshop, that's all gravy. But guess what? We have to innovate the technology, make sure we're using this as a resource to get the information out there. And I commend you because I think one of the things you said was, I'm not too tech savvy, but you stepped out there and guess what happened? You found the team to support you. And that's all we're saying. Step up, step out, and guess what happens? Amazing things happen. So we're going to have a great webinar. The information is on the screen, you guys. You can click on the chat box as well. Click the link. It'll take you directly to register for March 7th. That's 2018 at 7 o'clock Pacific time. And again, it's great to be a part of this. So you'll hear from real estate professionals, attorney, lender, HUD counselor, to equip you and arm you with this information to really be preventative. I think doctors say it all the time, right, Jen? Mm-hmm. Prevention is the best form of treatment or best form of care. So any last remarks you want to share?
Just thank you for giving me the opportunity to share this information. And you guys, let's get together and let's do it. Let's make some good things happen in the community.
Absolutely. Thanks, you guys. I will see you next week on Ready, Set, Real Estate. Stay tuned for phenomenal things.